everyone. Today we are going to learn about colorimetry and colorimeter. Why learning about colorimetry is important? Because working of biochemistry analyzer in clinical laboratory is based on the principle of colorimetry, and it is used for estimation of concentration of various analytes like glucose, urea, creatinine, protein, etc. in the biological fluids like blood, CSF, urine. And this is used for diagnosis of various conditions, prognosis, follow-up and monitoring of patients. First year MBBS students can have a short answer question on this topic. BPMT and DMLT students can have long answer question. At the end of this session, the student should be able to describe the principle of colorimetry, relationship between absorbance and transmittance, derive formula for concentration of analyte, components of colorimeter and their functions and applications of colorimeter. What is colorimetry? It is related to color. Colorimetry refers to measurement of intensity of color. What is color? Color is what the eyes see when light is reflected off an object. Color is a reflected light. Then what is light? Light is a form of energy that helps us to see things around us. Because of light only we can see the things around us, and it is made up of wavelengths, and each wavelength is a particular color. The color we see is a result of the wavelength which is reflected back. The visible spectrum of light extends from 400 nanometer to 700 nanometer, that is WBGYOR. Human eyes can only see the visible spectrum of light. The wavelength below 400 nanometer are ultraviolet rays, which we cannot see with our naked eyes, and above 700 nanometer are infrared rays. Colorimetry uses this visible range of light, that is 400 nanometer to 700 nanometer. The basic question is why the particular color appears of that color. Means, for example, why red flower appears red and green leaf appears green? Because the red flower reflects red light and absorbs all other light from the visible spectrum. Likewise, green leaf reflects green light and absorbs all other wavelengths of light. What is the relationship between absorbance and transmittance? When light passes through a colored solution, some that is called as I0, that is incident light. Some amount of light is reflected. Some amount of light is absorbed and some amount of light is transmitted. It is denoted by IE. And transmittance depends on nature of light absorbing substance, concentration of that substance, wavelength of light and length of path. That's why transmittance is inversely related to absorbance, and it is denoted as T is equal to IE, that is transmittance, transmitted light upon I0, that is incident light. Now let us talk about principle of colorimetry. Colorimetry, as we have said, it is the measurement of color. Concentration of substance is directly proportional to the color intensity. Means by concentration of substance. The principle of colorimetry and the relationship between color intensity and concentration is shown by two laws, Beer's law and Lambert's law. Let's first understand Beer's law. For example, this is a sample colored solution. When monochromatic light passes or fall on this colored solution, some amount of light will get absorbed and some amount of light will get transmitted. If the color intensity is increased and concentration of substance is increased, When monochromatic light falls on the color absorbing medium, as the concentration increases, color intensity also increases and you can see absorbance also increases. It means transmittance decreases. Again, if we increase the concentration of a substance, the color intensity will be more. And if monochromatic means a light of single wavelength. When it passes through the solution, as the color intensity and concentration is increasing, the absorbance is also increasing and transmittance decreases. So what you have observed here, the color intensity, concentration and absorbance, they are running in same directions. They are directly proportional, while transmittance is inversely proportional. So what Beer's law says, when monochromatic light is allowed to pass through light absorbing medium, as the concentration of substance increases, the transmittance decreases exponentially and absorbance increases. This is Beer's law. Now let's talk about Lambert's law. Lambert's law is related to length of path. It is the distance or diameter of a tube which holds the colored solution. Means it is the distance traveled by light. So you can observe that each tube is having different path of light. Means path of light is increasing. When monochromatic light falls on this light absorbing medium, in the first tube you can observe some amount of light is absorbed and some is transmitted. In the second tube, where length of path is more than the first tube, the absorbance is increased and transmittance is decreased. In the third one, again the length of path is more than the first and second tube, absorbance is more and transmittance is less. So we can say that as the length of path increases, absorbance increases and transmittance decreases. Here, the color intensity of solution is same and concentration is also same. Length of path is directly proportional to absorbance and inversely proportional to transmittance. So what Lambert's law says, when monochromatic light is allowed to pass through light absorbing solution, as the length of path increases, the transmittance decreases exponentially and absorbance increases. This is Lambert's law. If we keep length of path constant by using the same cuvette, the Lambert's law becomes inoperative and Beer's law becomes operative. Then it becomes Beer's-Lambert's law, which states concentration of substance is directly proportional to absorbance and inversely proportional to transmittance. In the earlier slide, we have seen the relationship between absorbance and transmittance. T is equal to IE upon I0, that is transmitted light upon incident light. If we make it in percent, so percent transmittance is equal to 100 multiplied by IE upon I0. If you shift 100 to the other side, then you can write IE upon I0 is equal to percent transmittance upon 100. How absorbance is related to transmittance? There is inverse relationship. Absorbance is also known as OD, which means optical density. And A is equal to OD is equal to negative log of transmittance. Now T is denoted here as IE upon IA. So T is replaced by IE on I0. This IE upon I0 is percent transmittance upon 100. So that is replaced by IE upon I0 is replaced here by percent transmittance upon 100, which can be further written as log of, it is simplified as log of 100 minus log of percent transmittance. Absorbance is equal to OD is equal to log of 100 is 2, 2 minus log of transmittance. Optical density means absorbance also depends on certain criteria like the nature of substance, the wavelength of light, concentration of that particular analyte and length of path. So we can also write it as OD is equal to KCl, that is K is coefficient of for that particular substance, C is concentration, L is length of path. If we take two solutions of same substance but different concentration, one is standard, the concentration of which is known to us, and unknown, the concentration of which we want to find out. Then the absorbance or OD of standard can be written, or it is related with KS, CS and LS. K is a constant coefficient, C is concentration and L is length of path. OD of unknown is equal to KU, CU and LU. As we are using the same substance, so KS and KU will be cancelled. We are using same cuvette, length of path will be constant, so it will be cancelled. OD of standard becomes, is equal to concentration of standard. OD of unknown is equal to concentration of unknown, which can also be written as OD of unknown divided by OD of standard is equal to concentration of unknown upon concentration of standard. Now we want to find out the concentration of unknown. We will shift this concentration of standard to this side. Concentration of unknown is equal to OD of unknown upon OD of standard multiplied by concentration of standard in milligram per ml. We always do not take the solution in 1 ml only. It can vary. So we have to multiply by volume of standard and volume of unknown here. So concentration, it becomes OD of unknown upon OD of standard. Concentration of standard in milligram per ml multiplied by volume of standard. Most of the units are in milligram per deciliter. That's why we will multiply it by 100, and now equation becomes the volume of unknown will come to this side, and the concentration of unknown in milligram per deciliter is equal to OD of unknown divided by OD of standard multiplied by concentration of standard in milligram per ml multiplied by volume of standard multiplied by 100. Why we are multiplying by 100? Because we want our unit milligram per deciliter. If we want in liter or gram, we can make those modifications accordingly. And this 100 is divided by volume of unknown. I have written, actually it is an effective volume of unknown sample, because in many experiments we have to dilute the sample. According to dilution, this can change. That's why it should be effective volume of unknown. This is how we can find out the concentration of unknown sample in a biological fluid like blood, urine, CSF, etc. In quantitative experiments, we take three types of tubes in which we take solution, and we label them as blank, standard and unknown. Standard is a solution which concentration is known to us. Unknown, in the unknown we add unknown sample, the concentration of which we want to find out. And why do we use reagent blank? But before that, let me tell you, there are two types of blank. One is reagent blank and other is water blank. What is the use of water blank? This water blank is used to calibrate the instrument colorimeter. This colorimeter, we have to set the OD to 0 and transmittance to 100%. As distilled water is transparent and we are setting OD to 0 and transmittance to 100%, means we check whether our instrument is properly calibrated and it is performing correctly. What is the use of this reagent blank. You can see here in the reagent blank, we just add reagent. In the standard tube, we add reagent plus standard sample. In the unknown, we add reagent plus unknown sample. The OD of this blank that we get is the OD of reagent. The OD of standard that we get is the addition of OD of reagent plus OD of standard sample. And OD of unknown is the addition of OD of reagent plus OD of unknown sample. In both standard and unknown, the ODs is contributed by OD of reagent as well. So we have to find out the OD of reagent to subtract it from OD of standard so that we can get the actual OD of standard and actual OD of unknown. Means we have to nullify the effect of OD which is contributed by reagent blank, and to nullify that effect we use reagent blank in experiment. So our formula becomes like this. Concentration of unknown in milligram per deciliter is equal to OD of unknown minus OD of blank upon OD of standard minus OD of blank multiplied by concentration of standard in milligram per ml multiplied by volume of standard multiplied by 100 upon effective volume of unknown. Now let's talk about components of colorimeter. Colorimeter has light source, entrance lid, condenser, filter, cuvette and cuvette holder, photocell, galvanometer and display in digital colorimeter. Now let's see the functions of components of colorimeter. Light source is usually a tungsten lamp which emits the light in visible range only, that is 400 to 700 nanometer. Entrance lid and condenser helps to form parallel rays which should fall on the filter. The function of filter is to allow only monochromatic light to pass through the cuvette. Means this is a green filter, so it will allow only green light to pass through it so that the green light will fall on the solution which is present in cuvette. What is cuvette? It is a glass tube of 1 cm diameter and uniform thickness. It should be transparent, clean, free from scratches and contamination. Depending on the concentration of solution present in the cuvette, some amount of light is absorbed and some amount is transmitted. The transmitted light falls on photocell, and photocell detects only transmitted light. It converts light energy into electrical energy, and we get to see OD. It is in the form of OD on the display. The function of colorimeter is to show the absorbance. Though photocell can only detect transmitted light, but it gives the reading as absorbance. The next important question is, why do we use complementary color filters? Here in this picture, you can see that green color filter is used for the solution having purple color. These two are complementary colors, and the aim of using complementary color is to facilitate maximum absorption. So while using colorimeter, depending on the color of solution, we have to adjust the filter. For example, for this light blue color, red filter is used for purple one, green color is used for yellow, blue color is used. So the complementary color use will facilitate the absorption, and we can get OD with the help of that. Applications of colorimeter. It is used to measure the optical density, and in turn, if we get optical density by putting those values in the formula, we can get the concentration of various biochemical parameters like glucose, urea, creatinine, protein, etc. in the biological fluid. Nowadays, with the advance in science, we have automated biochemistry analyzer wherein we don't need to use the formula and calculate ODs. We directly get results. If we keep the sample in automated analyzer, we get the result. But the principle of colorimetry remains the same. The same principle is used in spectrophotometer and other automated biochemistry analyzers as well. That's why understanding the basic principle of colorimetry is very important. The next video is on working of a colorimeter and verification of Beer's and Lambert's law, in which I will show you how to use colorimeter and how to perform experiment for verification of Beer's and Lambert's law by using copper sulfate solution. If you find this video useful, please like, share and subscribe and write your queries in the comment section.